Hey guys, and welcome to a brand new episode of Pokemon Go. I'm very excited for today's episode because we just got an update from things that we all wanted. First off, the tracking system is definitely now going back to Pokemon Go. Now, Niantic did confirm that they are working on it and we might see some changes during the next couple of days, but either way, it's just great to see it working again. So that's props to Niantic. I'm really glad you guys are putting this back. Also, another major change, it's excellent, great, and nice throws. We're now getting the experience back. As you remember from before, this used to be working just fine. 10 experience points for nice throws, 50 for great, and 100 for excellent. So having those experience back are awesome for all of us. Now, the third thing that we had was the battery saver mode is added again for iOS users. Now, if you're an Android, you might be saying, well, I've already had this feature. Yes, but iOS didn't. We had this removed on the last update. And if you do remember, the last update was only for iOS and they did remove battery saver. Now, if you're wondering how do you use battery saver mode, it's very simple. You go into settings, you mark the checkbox, and once you turn your phone upside down, it will shut down the screen. But it's not gonna change anything on your gameplay. It's still gonna count the mileage, it's still gonna count everything. If you find a new Pokemon, it's gonna vibrate. Just the same, it's just gonna save a few battery. Now, while you're on that menu, you might be seeing something different. You can now rename your character. So if you made a mistake, or if you now wanna name your character Team Geo, you can just go ahead and change your nickname. Now, this is a final decision, and you probably won't be able to rename it again. So please choose wisely, guys. Don't go overboard, because you will need to choose your name once, and that's it. Now, another great feature that I'm all for it, and I think it's good that it's added. It's gonna have a little task for you to do while you're driving. So let's say you're on a bus, you're not the actual driver, and you're playing Pokemon Go. It's probably gonna ask a question, you just answer or click something, and there you go. You can still continue to play. Now, if you're driving, you cannot just answer so quickly, so it's probably gonna shut you off the game. Now guys, this is a great feature because it makes people stop playing while driving. Now, I know it's a bit sarcastic because, last gameplay I did play on my car. But guys, it's for safety reasons, so I'm all for it. Again, Niantic, good job. But yeah guys, I just wanted to update you guys on all the information of this update. We have many great new things. So expect tomorrow gameplay, as I promised. I went to a very far away place with very little Pokestops, no gyms at all, and I'm gonna show you guys a few tips and tricks that might help you on your journey. Once again, stick around. I'm really glad you guys are following me. I thank you all, and train on.